There are many social media sites like Facebook, Instagram, etc. which people normally use for their personal life. But even professionals use it for expanding their business in a different way. LinkedIn is purely for professional networking. But Twitter is a platform which you can use for both, for expanding your business as well as for professional networking. Hi Vedic Lawyers, Prasanna Naidu here. In this video, I am going to tell you some tips which you must keep in mind while starting on Twitter. I would suggest you to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so that you will get notified whenever we upload such videos. But why Twitter? There are around 30 million Twitter users in India, out of which 80% of the users use Twitter on their mobile. Other platforms work well with long stories, but Twitter is a platform which is based on tweets, not more than 280 characters. So that's why you must use Twitter, because it will take less time as compared to other social media platforms. Even if you are in the middle of something and you have around 5 to 10 minutes, you can still get some work done on Twitter. Let's go through some basic tips which you must follow when you are starting with Twitter. Anyone who visits your profile will read your bio first and then go through your tweets. So bio is very important if you want that profile visitor to follow you. It is important for the Twitter's search engine too. What information you place in your bio also tells Twitter about you. So when someone searches those terms which are in your bio in the Twitter search bar, then all categories related to that search term will appear in the search results. Try adding some hashtags relevant to your industry in your bio. Keep it very clear and crisp, because you have to describe yourself in just 160 characters. Your bio must immediately grab the visitor's attention and compel him to know more about you. For example, you can add things like your practice area, expertise, your achievements, etc. Many people add their political beliefs, religious beliefs, and things like that. If you are using Twitter to grow your professional network and also to reach potential clients, then I would suggest you to do not add such things in your bio, because it will keep aside some category of people completely from viewing your profile and following you. But finally, it's completely your decision. Profile image. Use a professional image if possible, or else at least see to it that the image is decent and has a close-up view where your face is completely visible. Look at the colors present in your image, size and image clarity. Focus more on how it will look when viewed from a mobile, because most users use Twitter on their mobile phones. If you belong to a law firm, then use the firm's logo. Here you have to focus more on the size of the image and the image's clarity. Header image. This is a rectangular image which is displayed on the top of your profile. Even here, of course, you have to look after the image's quality and size. I am saying this multiple times because I have seen many people use the same image on all their social media platforms, and it does not work well, because each platform has its particular rules regarding the size of the image, which if not followed properly, then your profile will look ugly. The main point you must keep in mind when deciding your header image is that it must be an activity photograph. It means it must tell some story. For example, it can be an image of an award ceremony where you are receiving an award, or just the book cover of your recently published book. Username. What you see after the @ symbol on anyone's profile is his username. It is also known as Twitter handle. This username is your identity on Twitter. Don't use any fancy names. You can just keep your first name as your username, but it may happen that that username is already taken. Then you can try some variations like your name and surname together, or adding some description to your name. For example, if your name is Abhijit and you work in the IPR sector, then you can keep something like IPR Abhijit, something like that. But keep in mind that it is not too long, because this username will be used by other people to reply to you. Web URL. Whenever anyone visits your Twitter profile, then where do you want to send them? Think in those terms and then add a web link over here. It can be your blog, it can be your law firm's website, or it can be an Amazon link of your book. Location. Make sure that you have specified the correct location where you are working, so that the Twitter's algorithm can match up your content to the locally based audience. Hope you liked this video. If you did, then do share this video with your friends too. Like the video and also do comment if you have any doubts or even suggestions. I would be very happy to know your suggestions. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and if you have already subscribed, then don't forget to press the bell icon so that you will get notified about each video which I upload on this channel. We'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye-bye.